which is in charge of the Provident Fund Act 1952. Provident Act, or we can call it a PF. Basically, PF kyun dete hain hum log?
Savings
for savings for there are three conditions in which we give. Agar ye condition hai, condition one, if the candidate resigns or resign kar gaya ya uski death ho gayi ya retire ho gaya. Retire also called superannuation. So in these three cases, so PF is basically to have the monetary benefit. So that in case of candidate resigns, ya job chali jaye, ya death ho jaye, aur ya wo retire ho jaye, un cases ke andar kya hoga? PF ke andar yahan pe usko PF milega. Resign ke andar agar terminate ho gaya provident fund is the money, right? And death case ke andar usko insurance milegi. Retirement के अंदर उसको pension मिलेगी. This covers under the Provident Fund Act 1952. Clear? So under these conditions, so because in the government there is a security for the job. लोग इसलिए करना चाहते हैं, लेकिन private के अंदर ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. For that government has made this concept that Provident Fund is the one of the act that will save in case of emergency, in case of death, in case of retirement, you have some money in your account so that you can run your home. That's why the PF Act. ठीक है? Note करना इसको. Yes. I'll just note it. Applicable किस पे है? Organization with 20 and more employees. Organization with 20 or more employees will have to register under the Provident Fund Act. PF Act. They will need to submit their documents to the organization, and they will get the registration number, and it is applicable now on second on gross salary. There is some condition that is it is not applicable on it's some gross minus your one-time bonus or variable bonus. That can be, even you can exclude the variable. Gross minus employee variable. The variable from that differs from one employee to another employee. There is some condition that HRA is exclusive of this. There is a debate that someone is saying that HRA should not be included in this gross, but some say that HRA has to be there because the new law says that gross, it will be applicable on gross, and all the allowances which vary from employee to employee will be excluded from this. Vary means I am getting 500 rupees for TA, you are getting mobile expense for TA, something else. So that will be minus. But across the company there is a uniform salary. So we'll take the HRA, either you can exclude the HRA also, but there is a provision that it is applicable up to salary of 15,000 gross. Up to 15,000, you have to you can, it is your employer's responsibility or wish that he want to deduct or not. If he will be deducting, then he has to submit his own contribution also. Clear?
If the salary is below 15,000, then PF is not.
No, if it is below 15,000, then actual will be there. If it is suppose 25,000, and you want to deduct, you can deduct on calculate on 15,000.
Okay.
You can calculate on 15,000, right? Not on 25,000. So if it is 13,000, then you have to calculate on 13,000. Clear? So let's see the contribution. I am representing small e with as employee, capital E with employer, to avoid the mistakes between E and R. So employee will contribute 12% and employer will contribute 13%. Initially it was basic, now it's on the gross. So this will also called as account number 1, and this 13% will get bifurcated. Account number 1, PFE 3.67%, account number 02, admin charges, it will be 0.5%. Admin charges are for what? Admin charges are for government. It will not be reimbursed to the employee. Admin charges. And next is the account number 10, that is the pension scheme. Pension scheme is 8.33%. 8.33% is the pension scheme. Clear? To avail that pension, one has to contribute 10 years, up to 10 years of the contribution. He has to contribute to the EPF for 10 years. When he will reach at the age of 58 years, he will get the pension. Either you want to withdraw, you can withdraw the lump sum, or you want to have a monthly pension also. So you can avail the monthly pension scheme. That is a different formula. And then you have account number 21. This is EDLI, Employer Deposit Linked Insurance. In case of death of the employee, we have already discussed, he will get the pension insurance. He will get the insurance in case of death. So who will contribute to the insurance? Employer part will be added every month to the insurance. The employer will be giving contribution to the insurance. Clear? Then up to 20 times of the value, it may be now it increased to 40 times also, he will get the salary, lump sum amount up to 5 to 6 lakhs in case of death. In case of death, if he has worked for 1 year also, so he can avail the pension also in case of death. Clear?
This percentage is included in 12% and 13% or yeah?
12% is given by the employee. 13% will be given by the employer. That is the CTC, that will include in the CTC, cost to company, plus gross plus employer PF. That covers the CTC part. Clear?
जो 8.33% breakdown है, इसके अंदर included है 13%?
हाँ, if you calculate, it will come 13%, just calculate. These two will contribute at 12%, this is 13%. Clear?
So, let's see,
क्लियर हो गया।
सर पीएफ 15,000 के बेसिस पे क्यों हुआ?
क्योंकि इसकी सैलरी 20,000 थी, हमने काटना है इसको तो 15, तो हमने इसको अब बेसिक पे काटना है। जो पहले लैक्ट था वो बेसिक पे था कि 10,000 रुपये कटेगा, लेकिन अब जो एक्ट है वो 20,000 पे है।
अच्छा
ठीक है, तो 20,000 के ऊपर हम लोग अभी काट रहे हैं, तो 20,000 के ऊपर हम 15,000 ले रहे हैं। जो इसकी लिमिट है वो 15,000 की है, लिमिट जो है 15,000 की है, तो हमने काटना है तो हमारा 15,000 पे कट जाएगा ये। और हम बात करें इसकी कि अगर CTC की, तो CTC होगी 20,000 प्लस 13% इंटू 15,000, तो 20,000 1970 बनती है, 21,970 रुपये, 970 या 1950, तो यहाँ पे आएगा 15,000, कितना है आपका ये 1,800 × 15,000 × 15,000 × 15,000 3750, that is a calculation for the current fund. Clear? This is how we calculate the provident fund in this way. अगर ये 16,000 होता तब भी 15,000 लेते, अगर ये 12,000 होता तो हम 12,000 लेते, ठीक है? अगर हम अगर वैल्यू बढ़ती है, अगर आप देर, अगर एक बार किसी एम्प्लॉय का प्रोविडेंट फंड कट रहा था, सपोज 12,000 सैलरी थी, अब 25,000 हो गई, तो उसका कटता जाएगा, पर उसका कटेगा कब तक, 15,000 तक, उसके ऊपर वाला नहीं कटेगा। अगर इसकी सैलरी ऑलरेडी ज्यादा है, 40,000 है, और बेसिक जो है 20,000 से ऊपर है, तो 8,000 रुपये काटना नहीं काटना, क्योंकि CTC बढ़ जाएगी। अगर आप काटोगे तो आपको देना भी पड़ेगा, कॉस्ट टू कंपनी बढ़ जाएगी ना, कंट्रीब्यूशन बढ़ जाएगा आपका। क्लियर?
मतलब कोई अपर लिमिट तो नहीं है ना पीएफ पे, जैसे 15,000?
बस 15,000 है, 15,000 की लिमिट है कि 15,000 तक आपने ज्यादा आपने काटना है तो 15,000 तक काटो। क्लियर?
बहुत ज्यादा, जैसे 1,00,000 रुपीज,
उसमें ये डिपेंड करता है कि प्रोविडेंट फंड जो है वो प्रोविडेंट फंड जो है वो उससे पहले कटता था नहीं कटता। अगर काट रहे हो उसका तो आपको ज्यादा देना पड़ेगा 15,000 पे, और फिर 15,000 पे 1,950 रुपये काटोगे आप उसके।
अच्छा।
1,00,000 के ऊपर भी आप उतना ही काटोगे आप। हाँ, अब उसमें क्या होगा, एम्प्लॉई को इसको हम चलान बोलते हैं, कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन को, ये जो है पी एफ चलान आ गया आपका यहाँ पे, जैसे थे चलान, सपोज चलान ये रफ वर्क में है, इसको हम लोग ऑनलाइन करेंगे, ऑनलाइन वाला लेक्चर अलग से है, दिस इज अ वेरी बेसिक। तो जब एम्प्लॉई आएगा तो उसको UAN नंबर मिलेगा, UAN नंबर स्टैंड फॉर यूनिवर्सल अकाउंट नंबर, ये उसका वन टाइम हो जाएगा, आधार से लिंक्ड है, वन टाइम मिलेगा उसको हमेशा। अगर एम्प्लॉयर चेंज होगा तो उसी में सारा पैसा डिपॉजिट होता जाएगा हर बार, यूनिवर्सल अकाउंट नंबर, दैट इज UAN।
ये नहीं होगा एम्प्लॉयर चेंज हुआ पीएफ नंबर चेंज होगा, नो यूएन सेम रहेगा, पुराना एम्प्लॉयर यूएन को रिलीज करेगा, नए के पास आ जाएगा अप्रूव करके, ठीक क्लियर। दिस इज द प्रोविडेंट फंड।